We've all seen them. Classic TV shows. Our parents made us watch them in the hopes that we could finally have something in common to like. And some of them actually succeeded, like mine. Here's my top 10 favorite classic TV shows. The rules are as follows. The show had to have debuted previous to January 1st, 1980. So anything like Magnum PI, Remington Steele, and Cheers is out. The show cannot be a cartoon, so the Flintstones and the Bugs Bunny and Tweety show are out. It cannot strictly be made for children, so Sesame Street and Mr. Rogers are out. And remember, this is my list. These are my picks, my opinions. So if you don't like it, well, piss on you. I'm working for Mel Brooks. go make your own list. So, hey, I'm Phil from Produce, and this is my top 10 favorite classic TV shows. Number 10, Bonanza. It's incredible how a TV show can help sell things. Bonanza sold quite a bit. Not only were the Cartwright spokespeople for the Chevrolet Motor Company, they were also the first ever TV series to broadcast in color in 1959. Today's comparison would be high definition. Because of Bonanza, you'd have to imagine just how many color TV sets were sold. The show itself? It was a Western that was set in Nevada on a well-tended ranch called the Ponderosa. The show was so popular, its cast received plenty of fan mail, with Michael Landon getting the most. Pretty much all of them by young women. And speaking of Landon, he may or may not be on another show on this list later on. Hint, hint. Number 9, Hogan's Heroes. In 2003, TV Guide did a top 50 list of the worst shows of all time. And Hogan's Heroes was on that list. I haven't bought a copy of TV Guide since. Set in a German prisoner of war camp during the Second World War, it tells the tale of an American colonel guiding a group of two American sergeants and two European corporals on a series of missions and jobs to hinder their enemies' progress in the war, all while being friends with their enemies inside the camp. And how many of us wanted to give Sergeant Schultz a hug? Number 8, The Three Stooges. Lord knows just how many Three Stooges short films and full-length features have been made about the three bumbling laborers who can't seem to even handle the most menial tasks. While they may not count as a TV show since they never really made anything other than shorts and movies, their shorts have been rebroadcast on TV even to this day. On another note, this was probably the TV show that inspired Fred Rogers to start his show because he hated it. He said the first time he ever saw a television, all he saw on it was a bunch of grown men throwing pies at each other. And who wants to teach children to do that?
Hey, after all, I'm the sturgeon. Give me a little room.
Number 7.
The Rifleman.
Chuck Connors is a man to look up to. He's not just a stalwart hero who helps those in need, or a former baseball star who loved the game so much he got his name from it. He's also a gun-toting 6-foot-something badass that made memories for anyone who watched him. This was his breakout show, The Rifleman. The Rifleman took place in the West, in a place called North Fork. Connors plays Lucas McCain, a former member of the U.S. Army. After the war, he raises his young son and tends a ranch, sometimes calling upon his honed skills with a rifle to help those in need. An exciting show, a show that still airs on classic television. Number 6, Flipper. No theme song will ever stay with you as innocent and childish as this one. Set in Florida, Flipper is the story of two brothers who have a pet dolphin, and their dad is the local park ranger who raises them the way a dad in the 60s did. Stalwart and macho. Nowadays, TV dads just get drunk and act lazy. Number 5, The Lone Ranger. Speaking of theme songs, take an American classic tune called the William Tell Overture, and you've got your theme song for the oldest well-known program in American history, The Lone Ranger. The Lone Ranger was the original hero. He fought for justice with his trusty Indian companion Tonto, helping those in need of his help in the lawless West. Number 4, Adam 12. This was Cops before Cops was even a concept. During the 1960s, when hate for the police was steadily growing, the media needed a way to help the newer generation have a better image of what their parents' tax dollars were paying for. And enter Pete Malloy and Jim Reed, two of the LAPD's finest. Set in Los Angeles in the 1960s, this show was just the everyday tales of two beat cops in the LAPD, and it was entertaining. But it was also a chance to see growth. We see young Jim Reed go from a 23-year-old rookie to a responsible hero and a father. We see the veteran Pete Malloy go from a beaten 30-year-old cop who watched his partner die to a man who became what most cops eventually do, used to their job. Number 3, Little House on the Prairie. 6 months ago, I would have never included this on the list. This series holds a trump card for putting itself this high. Not because it was the first ever classic TV show that I remember seeing at a young age. Nah, there was an actress that got her start on the show who went on to become one of the funniest animated characters of all time, particularly in the 1990s. You only have to look as far as the last few episodes. Willie Olson's wife Rachel, played by the one and only Sherry Stoner. Stoner went on to be Slappy Squirrel on Animaniacs. And that is why Little House got number 3, and there is no other reason why.
All right, Miss Squirrel. Just relax and watch the monitor. I'm going to show you scenes from Alan Alda movies. You'll be out in no time.
Couldn't you just hit me on the head with a hammer?
Number 2, MASH. There was once a time a show existed that not everybody could understand. It had a special type of humor that only intelligent people got. It was called MASH, a show that incorporated dark humor and sarcasm, which to this day still airs on many different TV stations. The show had a constantly changing cast, but the only three people that kept on the show were Alan Alda, Loretta Swit, and Jamie Farr. Originally, the producers of the show didn't want a laugh track, but the TV stations did. So they compromised a chuckle track, because the producers, they wanted laughter, but they also wanted to show that war is hell and it's no laughing matter. And the number one TV classic, Gilligan's Island. You know, if there was a show that defied logic to an insanely high level, but we were always laughing and enjoying the show too much to even care, it was Gilligan's Island. This show was for everyone. No matter who you are, you love Gilligan. The only two surviving cast members of this video's posting are Tina Louise and Don Wells. While Wells embraces her time on the show and still makes regular appearances talking about her time on the show, Louise hated what the show did to her career. At the time, Louise was a dramatic actress, and she felt like the show ruined that image for her, turning her into a comic bimbo. Natalie Schaefer, who played Mrs. Hal, also didn't like her role in the show, but had the grace to stick with it all the way through, even through the TV movies that came later on. But every other character on the show embraced their role as their career highlight, and that is why Gilligan's Island is number one. This is Phil from Produce, signing off.